Yo, what's up, everybody? Welcome to another episode of the Motostop Show right here in beautiful Jacksonville Beach, Florida, with the Big Deal Production Studio. Got my partner in crime back once again, the CEO of LiveRuthless.com, Mr. C-Rut himself. Carl, what's going on, brother? How you been?
Oh, man, it's so great to be back here with the Motostop Show and Big Deal Productions and ready to get this thing going again.
Absolutely. We're going to have a good time. We got a lot to cover. We're on live Facebook again for all of our archives followers. If you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you check it out. It's normally Tuesday nights is the night that we normally film and do everything. So Tuesday nights around 7 o'clock is when we go live. Unfortunately, due to some work and some stuff I have going on, I couldn't be live. So we pushed it back to Wednesday. Man, we got a lot of stuff to talk about with Seattle Supercross had just wrapped up. It was a fireworks show in itself.
Wow, what a race, man.
Tonight is going to be an action-packed night. So we're going to cover a little bit about the arena cross, the chase format that's going on. We got to cover our Plots MX training tip.
Yes, sir.
We're going to talk in depth about the Seattle race. We're going to talk about some winners, some losers, everything we got going on there. We're also got to talk about our Grind MX, the grind rider of the week. So really cool, somebody that put forth the effort. That's right. Make sure you check out grindmx.com. As well as something cool, we branched out. We reached out to another podcast, another Facebook Live show, the Weekend Race Report. Poi Dog on NDA Action or NDA Action Sports, I believe it's his website. We'll get you the link up there. I've been kind of sharing it, so make sure you check it out.
Yeah,
they go live at 8 o'clock tonight. Show. And we're going to jump on there at some point in time and be some special guests. As always on Facebook Live, we can see you guys jumping on there. We got Ryan Myers, my beautiful wife, just jumped on there. That means Little Moto. He's been out there training in the turn track today. He's been putting in the work.
Keep it twisted, buddy.
He's probably on there watching and a bunch more. So, yeah, let's jump into this thing, man. Arena Cross. So those of you guys aren't familiar with Arena Cross, obviously it's a little bit different than the Supercross format. They have a chase just like a NASCAR. So it's a first nine rounds, takes you into the chase. And once you're in the top 10 points after the ninth round, you're able to go ahead and be part of that chase, I guess you would say, to the championship. So up until round nine, Jace Owens, the tie loop Honda rider out there, was just freaking dominating.
Killing them.
Multiple wins. Nobody could touch them. Well, come round nine, right there, Moto said, hi, Carl and Daddy.
Hey, buddy.
So come round nine, everything resets. Now, if you're the leader in the points there, you get a few points, gap, but it's like one or two. It's not a whole lot difference. We are currently three rounds into the chase with two more to go. We're looking at April 22nd. We'll be in Denver, Colorado, and then May 5th, the final in Vegas. As we stand right now, Gavin Faith is taking the lead. So as a dominant performance from Jace Owens the entire first nine rounds, how would you feel, Carl? I don't know if I like this format or not, but how would you feel? You're badass, and you're winning, and then all of a sudden they say, hey, restart everything. We're going to start over.
There's got to be a reason behind it, I mean, they've been racing the arena cross for so long. They're maybe trying to mix it up, maybe make it a little bit more entertaining, But I don't know that I'm a big fan of it. I like the guys to run, from one end to the other of a season, But make sure you guys comment on Facebook and let us know what you think about what y'all's feelings are about that format. I mean, I don't watch a lot of arena cross. I really enjoyed it at Atlanta. They all came together with the Supercross, and I like the racing a lot. While I was there watching the racing, it was some very intense racing. I like how they broke the format up. You saw a lot of racing. My parents went with me and we watched it together, and that was my dad's comment. Boy, we saw a lot of racing tonight.
Yeah, we see Damian Plotz just jumped on.
Said it's a circus.
No, he said it's a damn circus right there. And a man that probably spun more laps in arena cross than any of us ever think. He's definitely got the inside right there. So I get it for the spectator's point of view. It is entertaining and it does draw the crowd back in. But again, it would be hard for me as a racer to put forth that effort. And I guess you going into the series, you know what is going to happen, but damn, I think it sucks, especially for Jace Owens. Because now, Gavin Faith leads the series on the Babbitt Kawasaki at 135 points. In arena cross, you do get points for qualifying, and you do have the heat-to-heat races, so there is a little difference. There's able to be made up. Like you said, it is more intense. It's really cool racing. guys, make sure you check it out. The series is really coming together right now. Like I said, two rounds left. The final is going to be in Vegas, and the way they normally do this is the final for the arena cross is going to be on Friday night, and then you have the Las Vegas Supercross final on Saturday night, and then all the amateur finals, which I know we have a lot of our riders going out there.
Yeah, so that'll be an awesome event to go to, like Atlanta, where they had it all together, all that racing. Arena Cross really does a good job of getting the fans to relate to the riders. They do that pit party, you know, where the fans come down on the track and have a good time with all the riders and, you know, really have an intimate experience with those riders. And I think it really builds the sport of motocross. So Arena Cross is definitely doing a great job of promoting their events and keeping the racing going on while you're there attending an event and watching it.
Guys, make sure you stay tuned to that. And we're going to talk about our Plots MX training tip of the week here coming up very shortly. John Mortberg on there. That's a little ripper right there. Logan Mortberg, the 317. He's qualified for Vegas, going to head out there. So I know he's pretty stoked. I know we got a lot of our friends getting ready to go out there. It's going to be a good time. Well, let's dive into a little bit of Seattle.
Woo! Man, what a race. Hey, Aaron Plessinger.
AP.
Woo! Man,
son,
that boy was on it.
AP 23, wide open.
That Woods racing came in handy, huh?
It did. So, you know, different techniques for different people. And Aaron Plessinger, we've been waiting for him to shine. And these races where the ruts get deep and the tracks are really technical, which Seattle was, the Seattle track, not that it really broke down, but the ruts just got really, really deep, really soft dirt. So he was able to use that speed that he's learned out in the woods racing all those years. And a cool interview I heard from him, they said that his dad taught him when it gets rough, the faster you go, the easier it was. And
yes.
He
just skip over all that stuff.
He executed that.
He's riding on the back wheel. He's riding on the back wheel all over that track.
Perfect.
It was awesome to watch, man.
So in the 250 class, we'll talk about it right here. So you got Marty Davalos out with the whole shot.
Martin
Davalos, and it looked like he was going to do pretty good, but
that Husky was hooking up.
It was, and you know, mistakes is what's caused Martin Davalos to be in the 250 class, I believe, for the last 12 years.
Yeah, to keep him there. That's what kept him there.
He's got to be able to come and rise above those mistakes. And I thought, you know, down there training with Ferry, be able to do so much better, but I don't see the results. I see a little bit smoother, but this track got rough. He's got more experience than everybody on that track, and he wasn't able to navigate that track like some of the rookies out there. So I don't know what he needs to do. Maybe it's a 450 ride, maybe it's a different ride. I don't know, but something's got to be done with Marty Davalos and figured out what is going on. Tyler Payne said it.
T-Pain.
Faded so bad. I mean, he did. He faded.
T-Pain's faded.
So.
There's Kim Ingram coming on, too.
Moto
Faith Ministries.
Moto Faith Ministries.
We welcome that family for sure. And old T-Pain, man. Throw us a fish down or something, Tyler Payne. Come on.
So what about Justin Hill?
Oh,
so
man.
Solid second place ride. Coming from the back of the pack. And a rutted track, put in solid. Now, I don't think he had anything for Aaron Plessinger, even if he had a great start.
Yeah, he was a different level. Plessinger was a completely different level.
On fire, wasn't he?
Yeah, I think he could have smoked the 450 class, man. He was going.
And how devastated was he in that first one? In the 250 class, they red flagged. You know, Plessinger got out front, started putting in solid laps, and red flag came. Now, obviously, the red flag came for a good reason. Anytime a red flag comes, it sucks because there's a rider down, and it, you know, we're all about rider safety. I don't care if you're trying to win $1 million or anything. Most of the time, we're friends with the people, whether it's local races or pro races. We're friends with the guy on the track, and it's devastating to go around and see somebody land on the track. So,
yeah.
I appreciate when they red flag any race, and
it bursted his bubble, though, man.
It did.
Boy, it threw the wind out of that sail, man. He was definitely let down on that one. That was probably the first time he had put together that good start. He was going to win that race and had to come back and reboot. And he just prayed he got another good start and could put it together again. And when it turned around, he didn't have a good start. He had to work for it again.
He did. So he came off, I think, about sixth or seventh, and I'm just going off memory there. But
started passing him like that, though.
Yeah, so he didn't have a great start. Focused, wide open, pulling the trigger on that rhythm section. going 2-3-3.
Wow.
You want to talk about sketchy and rewatching the race?
The ruts and the jumps that he was doing it in and all. I mean, that was gnarly. That was just gnarly.
It was. Now, I know we watched a little bit earlier where he came into that second section, and when he hit that triple, it blew him up in the air like this right here. And literally, I mean, it looked like he was coming off the bike, but he was still able to finish the rhythm section out. That's just the confidence that Aaron Plessinger had in himself that night, ripping that track, that Yamaha. That Yamaha bike was working good.
Yeah, he owned that track for sure, man. And like you said, it's been a while waiting for that kid to shine, and he shined like a diamond.
He did.
The other night in Seattle. I mean, it was, what a performance.
And it kind of looked like a friggin', where they'd go mining for diamonds in that track, that dirt.
Oh, it was horrible.
So Damian,
man, I wasn't riding.
Damian Plott says about Marty Davalos making a great life getting top fives, why risk? Yeah, I mean, you know, I agree. He's made a great living and continues on. But how much longer is he going to be doing that? He's 31 years old now?
Well, T-Pain sharing us out there. You guys share us, let everybody know that we're on out here, build the audience.
Absolutely. Guys, yeah, thank you, Tyler.
Bobby Williams, look at that guy jumping on. Pro action in the house.
That's my boy, Bobby. So make sure you share, like, subscribe. Don't forget, if you can't get on live Facebook feeds, we do have the motostopshow.com. You can check out all of our archives page. Like the subscription. We're trying to build our Facebook or our YouTube up, so make sure you you like it, you subscribe, you share it. And you can also find us on TuneIn, iTunes, and Stitcher Radio in case you're driving across the country and you just need something in your ear to listen to and you can't watch the show. Aaron Plessinger with his second career win. Anything else stand out to you in that 250 class?
Hill had a good performance. Gosh, I'm trying to think. There was a rider that was on the tip of my mind, and now it's of course escaped me.
You know what we got to talk about?
You got the results there?
I do right there. Yeah, absolutely. So something we got to talk about is the 250 practice crash between Aldrege and McElrath.
Sore ribs. Yeah, sore ribs for the rest of your life.
Dude, big shout out to Chris Aldrege. Hope you're doing all right, dude. He, if you guys haven't seen it yet, so Aldrege comes to the rhythm section, gets a little squirrely, lands sideways in the goalie of another transfer, right? Well, McElrath is coming in, can't see anything, and when he comes in, as he sees it, he tries to move to the right, and when he does, his front tire plows Aldrege. So imagine me laying down here, his front tire comes in and plows Aldrege, and he just folds, dude, like literally folds in half. And right then and there, my heart like just sunk. And I was like, oh my God. The clip will be piped into our YouTube video. Damian Plosh just asked, where's the clip? So it will be piped into our YouTube video. So make sure you check out the full video. And that's something with Facebook Live. We're still learning. We don't know how to pipe in all those videos. But our full edited show is on our YouTube page. So make sure you check it out there.
That rider I was thinking of, CJ, was Mitchell Oldenburg.
Yeah.
Oldenburg, boy, he put in a good ride on the KTM.
He did.
He did a good ride on that 28.
He did. So, Aldrege, we're hoping you feel better. I actually reached out to try to get him on, but I figured he was in the hospital.
That was a hit, man.
T4, T5, T6 was broken, I think. Claps
rib
lung,
or two, I'm sure.
Ribs. And for you guys that don't know and don't ride out there, I see a lot of people on here that aren't in the moto world. Supercross suspension on the bike is stiff as can be. Cat-like reflexes. Stiff as can be. So when he comes in, I mean, there's not even any spring. No. There's springs in there, but nothing to soak it up per se. So it just plows into the side of Aldrege. And McElrath actually flips over and, got hurt a little bit. He pulled off from practice earlier and then comes back to, what did he get there? To a fifth place finish. So a man that almost didn't make the main to come back to a fifth place finish is solid.
Yeah, definitely. And how about, what was it, Hill and Davalos? Did they get together and bump off the track? Was it Davalos?
It was.
Yeah, well, that was wild. Took the flasher out with them.
Good call. Woo! As they jumped up onto the on table.
That was a wild ride.
Davalos got cross-roaded. And when he came over, and very smart by Justin Hill for the Pro Circuit Monster Energy. Exactly.
He said, later, bro.
So Davalos comes over on the inside, like from the outside to the inside. And as soon as Justin seen it, he kind of put his elbow out, just like Carl was showing you. Therefore, to off-center Martin Davalos, Davalos wouldn't lean on him when he landed. So he Davos went off the side of the track, and Hill was able to continue on. But honestly, if Justin wouldn't have thought about that and they came together full-blown like this, ugly. They would have both went down and lost it.
Ugly.
Hey, we got to give a shout-out. We got Jason Frank on here. Woo! Jake Rakes. Jake Frank.
He's been racing those little RC cars
and stuff. Dude, and killing it. Went to a big race up there.
He did it, buddy. We're proud of you, man.
He's
no matter what you're doing.
He's a rookie in this freaking RC
Vinter
thing.
Time Deuces from Notarino there,
and
man.
And he's killing we love up you. There. Notarino, Frankie Fresh's dad right there.
And look at the big one joining in there.
I see him.
Jake Rakes, home of the big one. The home Larry's of the Giant big sub. One.
Those of you guys watch Supercross up in the Jacksonville area, you might see the Larry's Giant sub. You might see this beautiful face. Something like, hey,
your
bro.
Wife, actually.
Yeah, the wife is beautiful.
She was the beautiful face on the video, by the way.
Oh, I was just going like this. I didn't say who it was.
Oh, okay.
So, you know, you see the Larry's Giant sub commercial, and I have
yeah, that's a great commercial. It's cool. It's out. Cool. Yeah, it's cool.
So big shout out to Jake and Larry's Giant subs. As we roll down here, so we got Marty Davos with a fourth place finish, Shane McElrath fifth, Jimmy D in that sixth place, Hayden Melrose.
He was running good. Jimmy D was running good.
Hayden Melrose in that seventh, Kyle Chisholm back on Chizzy. The 250 in the eighth place, and Cole Martinez ninth, and Justin. Heft. I don't know how you say that.
Yeah, you did good.
The 244. Sorry, Justin, I don't know who you are, but I guess I better learn getting top 10s.
That's right, buddy. Good
and
job.
The 250. How about Dee Floyd out there? Dee and Mike.
Hey, girl.
Yep, Tampa MX joining us. So welcome to
She's
the Motostop
show.
Got
her little ripper out there ripping around.
Yeah, Zai. Yeah, killing it, bro. All right, so wrapping up the 250 class results. Pretty much all we got to talk about on that. We're going to jump into our Plots MX training tip of the week.
All right, what are we doing, man?
We got it. So,
what's the tip?
I'm going to tell you. Glad you asked.
Man, I need some tips. But.
So if you haven't heard last week's, if you haven't watched the show, make sure you go check it out. It's on our YouTube page. And Damien actually put together a cool little video, and he talks about re-gripping the throttle, which is very important. And when you listen to how
the
he breaks
re-grip,
the dip,
the re-grip. I've heard of the re-grip.
So most people don't think about it, but
RJ,
if you go back.
RJ Hampshire.
Re-grip.
You got to re-grip it, bro.
Son, grip it and rip it. Starting routine is crucial to consistent starts, right?
Yes.
In this Plots MX training tip, we're not going to cover the steps, all the steps in that routine, but we are going to cover a few. So this is what he says. There's two scientific facts when doing this. A calm body reacts faster. Fact number one. Okay?
Yes.
And when I was reading this, as he said it to me.
Yoga breath.
But I also went back to my fighting days. And most of you guys don't know, I was a fighter for a long time, MMA, traveling, did stuff. But and part of the coaching and the training is you have to calm down. So if you calm down, you're able to react. And when, you know, they tell you to breathe. So as soon as I read this, it clicked on me just like that. Our little homie, Dean
King,
Dias.
The King, Dean Dias. You're cute too, buddy.
Dean, we got to get you back up here. You got to come back up to WW or train up here on one of these tracks so I can get you in here. I feel bad for asking you to drive up all this way. All right, so back to fact number two. A person's reaction time is faster when viewing objects from his peripheral vision, which I didn't know this.
Yes, I've heard that on the gate too.
Okay.
Faulkner told me that on the gate about the peripheral vision of looking at the gate.
All right. So, with that being said, here's your Plots MX training tip.
Woo!
When the two card comes up, you want to close your eyes. You're going to take deep breaths through your nose and exhale out your mouth. While doing this, you're going to envision getting the perfect start. So now you're calming yourself
down.
That's
right.
Next, when the card goes sideways, you want to look roughly 10 feet past the gate, okay? And when you see the gate drop in your peripheral vision, you'll have a faster reaction time than staring at the gate. This is your key, your Plots MX training tip to get a professional start. So we got to thank Damien Plots for doing these for us. He's going to continue to do these for us every week, jumping on board with the Motostop show.
So before the two card is up.
Before the
look
two card
him.
Is up,
join
right there,
in there,
giving us tips on the go. He said before the two card is up is when you want to start your breathing and visualize and getting your good start. So if you guys want to get more of these tips or you want to find out more information from Plots MX, You can check, you can reach Damien at 570-490-5892 or search Damien Plotz on Facebook or Plotz MX on Instagram.
Yeah, Plotz a great guy, great trainer. If I'm not mistaken, when I was riding out of the tunnel at Daytona, I looked over to my left there. I think I saw Damien on the wall in the tunnel
you
of
did.
Daytona. I did, didn't I?
You did. So
was that him?
That was number 73 on the tunnel. He's got a
he
cool
shot
in there.
He was ripping it right there, buddy. So the proof's in the pudding, right? If you're in the tunnel of Daytona, you might know a little bit about motocross.
You've probably had one or two gate drops in your life. So a little background on Damien Plotz. If you guys haven't seen, he's on one of our shows, came in. We'll get him back in as a guest host very soon. Former factory Husqvarna rider, top 10. He made national numbers for many, many years, all the way down to the national number of 44. Very talented rider still out there, and now he's training at Bostwick Creek MX Park. So make sure you check him out.
There's his last tip. If you can see it, you can execute it, right there from Damien himself.
That's
so,
it.
That's like it. Like CJ says, if you're ready to improve your game, go get with Plotz MX.
So let's move on. Let's talk a little
four
bit.
Four 450s.
Let's talk about, yeah, let's just jump into the 450s. So, what did you think of the track, first of all?
Gnarls Barkley. It was crazy, man.
Was it insane?
It was insane. I was so glad I wasn't riding. Those ruts just scared me to death. They were on jump faces, they were in straightaways, they were through the whoop sections. It was gnarly, man. The heat races were real entertaining, you know. We had real good racing, I think, because of the track. It was like a man's track, you know what I mean? Some of those guys that could do good on these prep tracks, you know, these supercross and, you know, some of the arena crosses and stuff, they groomed the track all the time, but they weren't able to groom this track. They had to just leave it like it was.
Rutted, David Morningstar said, rutted glacier dirt.
Yes.
It was something.
That's exactly what I said it was.
Yeah. Yeah, it was crazy. So
sandy. It didn't look sandy, but it was very sandy.
Sandy and
you can see the roost behind it.
So something they did, which I kind of bothers me. So I hate when inconsistency plays out, especially with what they got going on. They had one practice, one 10-minute practice. So everybody made the main if you were in the A and B practice, which is cool. And then they shortened the mains.
Yes.
So...
I don't know why.
They said, you know, for track maintenance and so the track wouldn't get too bad. But here's the problem. Like, you know, what if? So you have these rules put in place. We went to a timed format, 20 minutes plus one lap in the 450 class. Okay. But what if we still had 20 minutes? What if they didn't shorten it down to, I think it was 17 or 18 minutes in the 450?
Dungy might have came back, huh?
Would Eli have passed caught Marvin?
Maybe. Maybe. So it was a gnarly track, you know. It was a man's track. I wish they wouldn't shorten the race. I mean, you've been to Daytona when we were out there jet skiing around the whole track. We didn't shut that one down.
No, absolutely
you know?
Not.
I mean, we didn't shorten anything there. I'm not sure it was even shortened laps, shortened minutes, shortened anything.
No. So it bothers me that they just come in and they wing it, I feel like, with...
I want to think it's for TV. And that's what irritates me a little bit about this type of stuff, like when you're at the race, I don't like sitting in a seat waiting for a commercial. Like, have something going on. Have some entertainment going on for the fans that are there. If you're wanting to grow your audience, you better make it entertaining. Like, you see a lot, like when we're at Daytona, when there's those lulls, a lot of those people aren't fans, like dedicated fans. They're there for a bike week. So when they're seeing that and there's a lull in it, you can hear them around you like, what's going on? What are they doing?
Yeah. Yeah, absolutely.
They're like, oh, it's a TV timeout, like in football, you know?
Absolutely. And I agree. They did do it for TV time, and it was so they'd have time to maintain the track and groom it. One, I thought it was really cool. I like to see tracks get rough like this because, two, if you're the ultimate fan that rides and know how gnarly our sport is, you can appreciate a track like this and see how hard it is with those ruts so deep.
Yeah, and I don't even think really I'd do one of the doubles, race. Like not one of them. Like
probably
the
not.
Ruts in them, it was like, man, wow.
And if you're a, you know, just a casual fan that doesn't know much about the sport, you watch this, it builds more respect for our sport because the racers are closer together and you see people making mistakes versus you find a hard one-line clay track and everybody's just rock, jumping everything.
Yeah, it's not as fun to watch.
Tomac checks out and it's not a race. So I think this weekend in Seattle actually did great for our sport and our industry as a whole. you know, creating excitement.
Right.
Now, the racing in the 450 class in itself kind of helped lead to that. And we'll start talking about the start here. So, what the hell happened with that Suzuki Tough Block?
Man, Emig put the announcer jinx on that thing. He said in the heat race that in the 450 main, something was going down with that Tough Block, and I'll be damned if it didn't happen.
It did. Hey, real quick, check out Bruce Kramer checking in from Orlando, MS.
Yeah, buddy.
So
he's at the spot down there. Man, I had so much fun in Orlando.
Yeah, it's
good. Last week for the series. Woo, that was fun.
So as you come off the start and make a left-hand corner of Seattle, they had a Suzuki Tough Block out there that just created havoc for majority of the riders. Dungy caught up to
it. Why was it this way?
Well, it wasn't originally, but if you watch, what happened is left-hand corner, I believe, let's see, so it was a Yamaha. I believe it was Cooper Webb that would have came in and actually did a really nice job, but he leaned over a little far and started kicking the block.
Moved it in.
So then after that, folded up, and that's when Dungy got into it and Tomac had a bad start, which created some excitement in the racing experience that we wanted to see as fans, because now we have our top two people in the series, Ryan Dungy, started from dead last. Eli Tomac, who had a horrible start and had to go all balls out and started pulling some stuff, which is really cool. He was, I believe, the first one to triple onto the single table into the table section. Now, as a man that's announced a bunch of races yourself, I announced a bunch of races. I'm watching this, and Ralph, halfway through this thing, after they've been playing on the TV multiple times, so you know he's seen it, he's like, oh, look at Tomac jumps onto the tabletop. And I'm like, that was, yeah, exciting, except for that was...
That's what he's supposed to do.
10 laps ago, but he started doing it. Like, I get it, they got so much shit to do, but sometimes I just want to bang my head and listen to them guys. Tomac coming through the pack, ripping. And if you listen to some interviews, it actually says, you know, he thought Dungy was ahead of him. He didn't know Dungy fell down.
Right.
Until he got up to the front. So he put his head down and he said, I just went balls out and to as fast as I could to the front of the pack. And that's what he did. Well, Dungy obviously could see everything. He's working his way, Dungy way, meticulously picking people off. But there was a sense of urgency in Dungy's riding style as well. I mean, he wasn't sitting back.
No way. No, he was coming.
Absolutely.
Dungy was coming. Like you say, if it would have went the distance, who knows?
He was on fire.
Who knows?
How about Cooper Webb? Tomac
Coops.
Keeps up to
Man, he was Super coming Coop at first.
And
battling
passes
Tomac.
Him.
He was battling Tomac.
He did. So he goes through the rhythm section. Tomac's out on the outside. And Tomac has to drive into the right-hand corner. Actually checks up. Cuts back under Coop. Goes down. Tomac had about two bike lengths going into the whoop section. Okay? And Cooper grabbed a handful
Super
of that
Coop.
Yamaha.
Super Coop. Super Coop. Shifted up.
Put the damn cape on
him.
Straight out. Passed him back. Takes the inside line on the next left-hand corner. Runs Tomac a little high. Clean racing. Wasn't
yes,
dirty.
No,
very clean.
Not at all.
And literally, I think Tomac wasn't prepared for that. And it dropped his lap times down to
It shut him down a little bit.
Yeah.
It shut him down a little bit. It's like, whoa, what just happened there, buddy? Cooper. Whoa.
Come back. He wasn't legit.
Let me regroup.
He had a Vancouver had a big get off though, and that made it about four or five laps to go, which sucked. But I'm glad he's okay.
Yes,
glad he's okay.
Yeah, Cooper's a good guy, man.
So Tomac, your fastest rider on the track, although he didn't win, he started in the back of the pack. He went down in that left hand corner coming out of the double. Luckily for him, as he goes down, he's able to get back up, and nothing was twisted. And for a man that rides a Kawasaki. And I see a lot of people on our Facebook Live that rides Kawasaki as well. And I couldn't believe how fast it started. He was back on it. Didn't even really lose a position hardly. Maybe to Jason Anderson. Able to get Jason Anderson back. So they finished. Marvin Muskan, his second.
Yeah, wow. What a ride out of him.
Absolutely. So, and you can't take anything away. It's hard to talk about him when you have rides like Ryan Dungy and, you know, Eli Tomac coming from the back of the pack.
Yeah.
Marvin just put in consistent, solid laps up front.
He did what you got to do to win.
Yep, he wasn't pulling
good
anything
start.
Big.
Good start, charge hard.
That's it. And
never
no mistakes.
Never look back, no mistakes.
No mistakes.
He's going to work on his victory lap.
He is.
Gonna, you know, he's going to go train for the victory lap performances.
So what Carl was talking about is as Marvin Musquin won the race, he pulls over and he stops up on a double. John Mortberg just said it. How about Musquin's victory lap? So here's what happened. He stops up on a double, takes his goggles off, and goes to throw them to the crowd, right? He does it to the crowd, and as he does that, he takes off, and there's a dragon's back right there. And he comes up, and he's going to wheelie tap. And he said in his post-race interview that, you know, I wanted to look cool and impress the fans. Well, he comes up over, and I'm not sure if he just made a mistake. He said he may have hit neutral, but I think really he just wasn't thinking about what he was doing. So as he comes up over this dragon back, his front tire drops down and plows into the next jump, which flips him over the bars, and he, right in front of everybody, has got to pick himself up off the ground, right? And, I mean, he didn't even look up at the crowd. He just shook his head and got on and gone. The best was in the post-race interviews. So Anderson sitting right to the left side of Marvin, and then you got Tomac, right? I think it was Michael Antonovich from Transworld actually said, hey, what about that wreck? And he goes, you know, Marvin started shaking his head and started talking about it. Jason Anderson didn't even know what happened. And Jason Anderson, who trains with him, then he started picking on him. He's like, wait, you wrecked? And if you watch the interview, it's epic because he unfolds right there, like figuring it out. And it was so epic to see how those two, and you can see the relationship that they have between Jason Anderson and Marvin Musquin and Ryan Dungey. Speaking of relationships, Ryan Dungey, Jason Anderson, Marvin Musquin, all ride for the same team pretty much now. Jason Anderson's on the Husqvarna brand, but it's it's umbrellaed out of the KTM branch, right?
Yes.
Hey, Dean's got a question for you.
Yeah, it's water, buddy. Zephyr Hills.
It's our training program. It says water in the cup. Is that water in the cup, Carl?
Of course.
It's a little protein. It's our protein shake for the night, you know?
We're training hard, buddy. I'm going to come back.
So, back to this relationship building and team tactics. Now, if you watch the race, I'm 100% confident that Millsaps let Dungey by to that fourth place position. You know, very easily let him go by, no holding it up, which is okay. Marvin was out front, so obviously Marvin wasn't going to drop back. Winning was the best thing he could do for the team. As we go into the break, we're off this weekend coming up, and then we will head to, where are we going? We're going to Salt Lake City. We just left Seattle.
Utah.
Salt Lake City, and East Rutherford, and then Vegas, right? Yeah, three rounds to go. So as we go into, we're off this weekend, go into the break, we come back. There's got to be some kind of thought process, whether you're Monster Energy Kawasaki or your factory KTM, about what's going to unfold, what's going to play, whether your riders are up front or if you're Eli Tomac, you're looking at it and going, okay, well, they got five guys out there that literally could screw me
Costa,
up.
Costa, yeah.
So what does Tomac do when he goes into this? You know,
man, you just got to ride smart. You got to keep it on two wheels, and you got to charge hard. He's got to get the start.
Starts are key, yeah. 100% the start. He probably needs to listen to
get in
our,
front of them guys,
our Plots MX training tip this week.
That's right. He better listen up, man. You better tune in, buddy.
Absolutely.
Eli Tomac, tune in there. Plots MX training tip there, man. Get you a good...
Damian Plots, get him tuned up, going
get
faster.
Get you a good one going.
Now, if you're Ryan Dungey, well, let me ask you this, Carl. So going into the break, they're off this weekend. Obviously, they're going to sit back. They're going to start training, you know, testing for outdoors. Who comes back in Salt Lake with confidence? Is it Eli Tomac that's won the last eight out of...
I think Musquin.
Nine races.
Musquin comes in there with some. But ready to show those boys, like, I'm not in the mix.
He's not in the title hunt, so...
But I'm in the mix.
Well...
I mean, let's see.
Let's see. So, Marvin Musquin, third
in
the
points. I think Dungey and Tomac aren't going to have the confidence. They're going to have to be on reserve. Like, man, keep it on two. Like, worried
you think
about the points. I know Dungy will be.
Well, Dungy.
Dungy will be thinking.
Do you think Tomac has a reserve
tank?
I'm
sure his dad has sat him down and said, son, you are this close from winning this championship. You have to keep it on two wheels. You got to keep it easy. Just get a finish.
I don't think John Tomac does that.
I don't know. Mean, I don't know what he does. He is. He's a badass. Hey.
I think John Tomac just says, look, go hold it wide open and win this shit.
Oh, my God.
Because we know that's what Tomac's going
to
do.
Yeah, I mean, all it would take is a tip over there to lose it all. Just one tip over.
It would, but, you know, sometimes
and what is it, three races,
to,
you say? Three
we got
left?
Three races to go.
Wow. I'm glad it's not me. That's all I can say. Damien, what does he do?
But he's in a good, he's in a good position, right? I mean, so at one point in time, he was down. I mean, after the first three races, how many points was he down? Something like 40 or 50 or 60?
I know.
I don't even remember
how
many
was. He's just that person that's been right there so many times and just,
and got it.
Just
so
kept it.
Tomac won, I believe, Dungy's won three races this year, and Tomac has won, I think, seven. Obviously, Tomac's the fastest rider on the track. I think as we go into the break, some outdoor testing, which Tomac loves outdoors. Ryan Dungy, I think it's going to be his last season, so he doesn't focus that much on outdoors. This is my opinion only. They're both going to come back refreshed, but I truly think Tomac comes back even better than when he left this week.
Yeah, he's putting it all together.
He did.
It's like when he wrecked on that Honda, what was it, a year ago in outdoors?
2 years ago.
2 years ago in outdoors. He was putting it together finally, and then that injury just jumped up out of nowhere. Look at Damien. Tells him to breathe.
Breathe.
And I think Mortberg's all over that one.
He There's said Tomac only has one speed. He isn't able to ride 80%. Hey, John.
That's true. There's riders out there like that. You've seen Stewart.
It is.
Stewart can't just chill out and ride. He's got to go, baby.
Stewart doesn't have an excuse. At least Tomac has an excuse. And we all know once you get on a Cowie, you're either wide open or you're not at all. So,
back tire riding.
Cowie's the way to go. That's what happened. John says that's what happened in 2015. He was trying to ease up and it bit him. He needs to just keep it
in ludicrous
mode.
That's right, brother.
Straight up wide open.
Yeah, he's an awesome rider and he's so fun to watch.
All right, let's run down these results here for the 450 main. Obviously, we know Marvin Musquin got first. Eli Tomac in that second place position. Jason Anderson in the third place position. Ryan Dungy coming back with a solid fourth place
last the
from
fourth.
19th. So
on
Eli,
the gnarliest track of the year.
Eli started in 10th and went down, came back to a second. Phenomenal ride. Ryan Dungy comes back from 19th to a fourth place finish.
I'm telling you, traffic was probably so hard on Dungy because of the track conditions. You know, guys are rolling stuff everywhere on the track.
Instead
of like one, they're rolling all the jumps. Yeah. I've seen guys just
Insane.
Rolling the track.
Insane. Could you imagine trying to hit that triple with those ruts?
Yes.
Davey Millsaps got the whole shot in fifth place. Brock Tickle, solid sixth place ride for that Suzuki rider.
So they gave Millsaps the whole shot.
That's what it says.
Yeah, I thought Anderson had it, but Anderson must have came around after that. Yeah.
So Blake Baggett in the seventh place position. Cooper Webb, even after that gnarly crash, comes back to an eighth place, and he was the second fastest qualifier.
Yeah, he was riding good.
Behind Marvin Musquin. So he was on fire. I think he's really starting to drive with that 450 and that factory Yamaha team. So.
Ben Reed and Dino wrapping up the 10.
Chad Reed coming back a little better finish, finishing ninth place. And Dean Wilson, like you just said, in that top 10. We're going to see Malcolm get better or what?
I would like to see Barsha come along. What has happened to my buddy Justin Barsha?
Besides he's an idiot?
Something. I thought Barsha was going to be a contender from the first time I ever seen that kid ride.
He is. He is so focused on T-boning people and taking people out right now that he can't even go straight around the track for 2 seconds.
Right.
It's ridiculous.
Put it together, JB.
He's got to figure something out. He's training back at Club MX, so maybe he's getting a different program. But that, if you're JGR, the owners of his team, okay, you're paying him millions of dollars.
He's one of your top guys.
What do you say to him when he comes back to the rig and, like, was it last weekend, I think? Not Seattle, the weekend before. When he literally just T-bones Alex Ray in the corner, what would you even say to the idiot when he comes back?
Buddy, what are you doing? You got to make the program. You got to make the mains. You got a top five for us.
Hey, you remember the guy that punched Marvin in the yes, chin thing? Yes. Like, good job. I think you do that to Justin when he takes his helmet off. You just fuck, whack him as.
Bam, like, bam.
Oh, my God. Justin in.
Look who's on.
I see Carrie on there.
Hey,
Carrie
girl. Green. That's my home girl.
So Ryder, little Ryder, is probably hanging around there in his cast, watching. He may be out shredding his quarter pipe or his half pipe in the backyard.
Man, he raced with the cast on, man.
You know, we got local racing coming up. We're off this weekend, but...
where are we going? Where's the next race?
Next round two, Bostwick Creek MX Park.
Bostwick,
23rd, I believe it is. So make sure you guys don't want to miss that. If you missed the first round, we had 400 and almost 40 entries. One of the biggest races that's hit Florida. So round two, we already got a lot of commitment from a lot of our guys coming out there. It should be just as big. And then round three, we'll be headed over to Dade City Raceway, another
yes, sir.
Fun track to go.
Well, he'll shape it up. It'll be a brand new track surface. He does every time. I've never been there where it's the always. Same track.
Always, yeah.
Dade City always doing so much work, man, on their course.
Randy Yoho
does great facility.
Great job out there. Hey, don't forget, we're tune in to the weekend race report at 8 o'clock. It's coming up right after this. So, Poy Dog, we'll have a link out there. Justin, I do, because you didn't send me one, buddy. So
J-Star's moving.
I know, going to Texas. I seen that.
Good luck out
Justin
there, buddy.
Justin Starling just asked, do I have my own jersey on display?
Of course.
So, funny little story. We used to have a green screen. If you watch some of our archives, we had a green screen where we were piping in video. But we were having problems putting the video up on YouTube because Feld is copyrighting, and like all we were doing was talking about it. We weren't trying to make money off it, blah, 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 blah. So he, Feld was copyrighting it and was having a hard time getting it up. So we removed the green screen part of our studio. Therefore, we just had a blue screen, and I just grabbed some stuff out of my house and put it up. So Justin, get us a jersey in here. This is actually the one I wore and destroyed my shoulder in Vegas at the Rallycross Finals.
Yeah, Justin, we need something. Where are you going, Colorado, buddy? We need something from the Florida boy in here before you take off on us, man.
Yeah, where are you going? He says not going
to
Texas.
I think Colorado is where he's going.
Is it Colorado?
Yeah, Rocky Mountain High over there, man. He's going. He's going to see Matt Johnson, man.
Is he? MJ. MJ's back, bro.
MJ in the house. He's a snowmobiler now.
No, he's got a bike. He's got a new 2016 Cowie.
I know you're all pumped on that.
Ah. Colorado, there you go.
Yep. Rocky Mountain High, brother.
Hey, you could hit up Haygoods, go out there a lot and see MJ. So,
yep.
Yeah, good time. Some Florida people out
yeah,
there.
Yeah, it's a beautiful place, man. Colorado is beautiful, Justin. You have a good time out there, buddy.
Absolutely. Keep in touch and let us know how it goes. We still got to get you on, dude. Anytime you want to come on, make sure you just let me know. We'll do a phone in and we'll talk about your season because it's been pretty good. You switching to your new team and everything, I think it's...
They were at a 250 against the 450.
He did.
Stuff.
And
he
did
had a
really
good time, man. He had a good time, man.
Sick out there. So, we're not going to hold you guys up too much longer. Anything else, Carl?
Mm-mm. I just appreciate you bringing us on and having a good time and bringing all this stuff and fun and entertainment to the people. And,
oh, we got our Grinder.
And it's up
Max.
To the guys. Oh, Grinder. What are you doing
Grind
for Grinder?
Max. Who's your
Jim Arbo Nasty.
Who's your Grind MX pick of the week? So,
for
it's
what?
Somebody. Here's how I pick the Grind MX rider. It's somebody that, did an outstanding race, whether it's the local races, the pro races, something that stuck out in your head. And I got a guy in mind, normally somebody I wouldn't ever pick, but you got a guy?
Local races, I do, Keith Ulrich.
Yeah.
Jumping off the bench, throwing in, I think he's raced four classes.
Oh, yeah, he's sick.
He's such a badass.
He's sick. So
Ulrich.
So my Grind MX pick of the week is going to be Ryan Dungey. Back to the pro race, just from, like we said, starting in 19th place all the way up to 4th. That guy had to really put down his head and grind. Make sure you check out grindmx.com. As everybody's jumping on right now, we're getting ready to wrap this up. But don't forget, you can check out our archives on themotostopshow.com. Subscribe to our YouTube page. Like and share. We got Brinsley Diaz down there from
MX.
Justin said he's going to hook us up with something. So we appreciate Starling out there. We appreciate all of you guys. Make sure you stay tuned every week. Motostop Show coming at you. We're going to host, or not host, we're going to be a guest on the weekend race report coming up at 8 o'clock. Make sure you check out Poy Dog's NDA. I'll get you a link coming up very soon. But we'll get to see what we got going on over there. Anything else, Carl?
That's it. I think Damon's putting in a throw in there for Addison Emery, I believe.
Oh.
538 for the Denver Arena Cross. We'll wish him well.
Addison going out there to represent.
Go get it, buddy.
That's it. Hey, make sure you check out liveruthless.com. A big supporter.
Sure. For sure.
Logan's watching. He said hi. What's up, Logan?
Well, Logan,
so
buddy.
Proud of you. Had to post one of your pictures today because it was pretty sick. Look at all the thumbs up we're getting right now. We appreciate everybody coming at us. Big longtime supporter, Carl Live Ruthless, CEO, right here in house with us. I appreciate it. Everything you do for me, keeping me fresh, dead, and all my gear. Make sure you check it out. Hit up liveruthless.com. Once again, we appreciate you guys. Hey, FMG on here as well. Andrew right there, North and South Florida, has MX covered.
Yes, sir. Florida Motocross Group.
We thank each and every one of you guys. We got to give a big shout out to our executive producer that's not here with us tonight. I don't know how we got through with the show, but Tom Dennison, we're missing you. Can't wait to get you back. Big shout out to Brian Douglas, our executive director, for holding things down. He's actually working.
Big deal.
You guys can't see it, but he's actually working four cameras back there with Instagram, Facebook, our regular YouTube page right there. He's got everything going. So make sure you tune in. If you like it, give us a thumbs up. Comment. Let us know what you guys want to see in the future. We're here for you guys. We're doing this because we love it. It's been fun. It's been real. We'll see you guys at the racetrack very soon, April 22nd, 23rd, Bosswood Creek, round two of the Florida, Georgia, Florida Motocross. My name is CJ Harris. I'm the host that tries to bring you the most excitement in the Florida Motocross community. This is Carl Rutledge from the Big Deal Production
Studio.
Peace out.